My name is Andrew Crowther. We're at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill. I'm a graduate student in the neurobiology curriculum. So it was in high school, I kind of was looking into how the brain functions. I do not have any scientists in the family. I think a lot of the creativity that my mother has been passed down, and it's helped me in science. It incited a pursuit that has led me all the way to here. We're looking at fundamental processes in brain development. So there's neurodegenerative diseases where the brain is wasting away to some extent. And then there's also areas of traumatic brain injury. We have a brain injury. So there's this concept that we can have regenerative therapies where we make more brain cells that can recover the brain in general and maybe add to alleviate the symptoms of these diseases. So our hope is that we have these stem cells we can put into certain areas of the brain that are diseased and then foster their growth so that they then contribute to that brain function that was lost. We are now, with technology advancing, able to look and watch. And when you watch, there's a lot more data when you have a perspective like that. We're headed to where choir images with a miniature microscope. Usually epifluorescent microscopes are pretty tabletop wise. And then this one has a camera and a little tiny lens. So we use that to image cells in real time.
I do know that in the bench.
They probably like it. All right. I'll show you some images acquired from the microscope. We're using computers a tremendous amount. And so I spend time at my computer where I'm working on analyzing data and also looking at even finer details than we can look at just by eye. Notice the characteristics of migration are present in this cell type that we're imaging. This would be an example. So up here is the time over hours of the imaging of the cells. It's in a movie format because you're able to record over time. And then we can take even more intensive pictures of the cell. We're looking at the side of the cell. It appears there may be one cell body, which is a different color code because there's more volume associated with it. And then one thing that's surprising is that when we do the 3D reconstruction, we can image and see that appearingly one cell now has turned into two cell bodies. This would be the birth of a nerve cell in the hippocampus. Cells are dynamic. We weren't expecting them to be so dynamic. They're looking, they're searching for something in their environment, and when they find it, the cell body will move. To make a connection between our daily experiences and cells that are moving in the brain has not been linked before, and if they are tied very closely, this is highly interesting and likely contributes to important brain functions.
Just something like colorful and cool.
Everything at universities in general that I've experienced and people that are doing research, if you go and ask them for help or for advice, they're going to offer it. I kind of enjoy working here almost too much. So everybody's thinking about translational medicine, how do you apply basic research to the medical side. I'm very interested in having new therapies, so that's my motivation. Yeah. The field in neuroscience specifically evolves very fast, rapidly. And so new minds work with new technologies the best, and they'll apply it different ways from what I could even think of for younger people.